everyone, to the first meeting of the Council of the Creek. We've gathered from all corners of the creek as equals to help make the creek a better place. Joining us today, we have the Sewer Queen, representing the Sewer Kids and their waters. Eustace, speaking for the Ninja Kids. Jason, representing the Forest Scouts. Cannonball for the 10 speeds. Paintball Mike, representing all the players in the Rainbow Alley. Then we have Kit, representing the creek economy. Wildernessa, for all wildlife. The Junk Lord, for all junk. Eliza, representing the Tea Timers. Ren, representing science. And Bobby, representing candy?
I'm your best friend, Craig. I'm here for you.
Although we're all free to play as we want at the creek, many of our games have rules. It's what separates us from the animals. But I think even animals could agree the circle game needs rules. Would anyone like to propose a rule?
I would. You shouldn't be able to make a circle above the water when someone is floating underneath. If they stay underwater, they could drown. And we probably don't want kids to drown.
Okay, no circle game under water.
And no circle gaming during very important business transactions.
And no shoving a circle in someone's face when they're trying to do a 360. It happened to me, and I only did a 180. It was the worst, man.
180s are the worst?
Got it.
What else?
We're gonna hear each other's voices. Do it for the creek. We're gonna make a bunch of choices.
No circling and driving. You must circle with the real hand, not a picture or artist's rendering. No circling by force. And lastly, the circle must be presented below the waist. Any circle from above does not count.
Okay, let's vote. All those in favor of the circle game doctrine, raise your hand.
You've been watching the Cartoon Network YouTube channel. If you want more awesome stuff like this, click the subscribe button.